मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस प्रतिमा, योर साइंस टीचर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सॉइल फॉर क्लास 8. ओके, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दैट देर आर मैनी एग्रीकल्चर प्रैक्टिसेस, लाइक फर्स्ट स्टेप प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सॉइल, देन सोइंग, एडिंग मैन्योर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स, इरीगेशन, प्रोटेक्टिंग फ्रॉम वीड्स, हार्वेस्टिंग एंड स्टोर. ओके, सो ईच स्टेप वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन डिटेल. क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? सो हियर फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सॉइल. वी नो दैट सॉइल इज वेरी वेरी एसेंशियल थिंग फॉर एनी फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ एनी प्लांट एंड एज वेल एज द क्रॉप. सो द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सॉइल इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप बिफोर ग्रोइंग अ क्रॉप. वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टास्क इन एग्रीकल्चर इज टू टर्न द सॉइल एंड लूजन इट. We know that after the crops are been harvested, after every season, what we need to do? We need to prepare the soil for the growth of next crop. Okay, we need to loosen the soil. This and what is the benefit of this? This allows the roots to penetrate deep into the soil. The loose soil allows the roots to breathe easily even when they go deep down in the soil. Why does the loosening of soil allow the roots to breathe easily? So as I told you that all the plants and crops, they are growing in the soil. So what happened when the soil are been loosened? Then the roots of the plant and crops can easily grow deep down, can penetrate the soil and can avail all the essential nutrients which are required for its growth. Yeah, next. The loosened soil helps in the growth of earthworms and microbes present in the soil. These microbes are friends of the farmer since they further turn and loosen the soil and add manures to it. Okay, as it is well known that earthworms are called as what? Friends of farmer. Why? Because they help in loosening of the soil and they increases the fertility of the soil by providing humus to the soil. Okay students, and there are various kinds of microorganisms which are present in the soil which also helps in increasing the humus quantity in the soil. Clear? You have learned in the previous classes that soil contains minerals, water, air and some living organism. In addition, that plants and animals get decomposed by soil organism. In this way, various nutrients held in the dead organisms are released back into the soil. These nutrients are again absorbed by plants. So as we all know that when any organism, living organism, especially any plant or animal, any animal, they get dying. So what happened after the important nutrients which were present in their body, that has to be released into the soil. And for these purposes, various kinds of microorganisms are being present in the soil. So that help in the decomposition of important nutrients from dead organisms. Clear students? So in this way, the release of the important nutrients takes place again back to the soil. And the nutrients are being available for their particular crops or plant for their growth. Since only a few centimeters of the top layer of soil supports plant growth, turning and loosening of soil brings the nutrient-rich soil to the top so that plants can use these nutrients. Thus, turning and loosening of soil is very important for cultivation of crop. Now, as I have told you that the process of loosening and turning of the soil is a very very important process in the preparation of soil because that helps in availability of the nutrients to the growing crops, and at the same time it will also help the roots of a plant to breathe well. Dear students, next it is the process of loosening and turning of soil is called tilting or plugging. So as we know that when we lose the soil and we turn, loosening or turning of the soil is called as what? Plugging or tilting, because this thing are be done either by by the farmers by using this method. Here in page number 3, figure 1.1, the plug. By this way, the farmers, what they do, they prepare the soil, and that helps in loosening or tilting of the soil. Understood, students? So this is done by using a plug. Plugs are made up of wood or iron. If the soil is very dry, it may need watering. Okay, before plugging, the plugged field may have big pieces of soil called crumbs. It is necessary to break these crumbs with a plank. The field is leveled for sowing as well as for irrigation purposes. The leveling of soil is done with the help of a leveler. Sometimes manure is added to the soil before tilting. This helps in proper mixing of manure with the soil. The soil is watered before sowing. So in this first step, that is preparation of soil, we have studied about what loosening of soil, loosening and tilting of soil, and it is been done commonly by the farmers by using various types of methods like by plugging. Yes, students? Okay. Next step, that is agriculture implements. Okay, so as we have already studied about what preparation of the soil, in that we studied how the loosening and loosening of soil is been important and all that things. Okay, so now second step, that is agricultural implements. Okay, so before sowing the seed, it is necessary to break soil to the size of grains to get better yield. So as we have already loosened the soil. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to break the soil into very small size, up to the size of the grains, so that what happens, it will be very beneficial for the grains to get better yield. Okay, so this is done with the help of various tools. The main tools used for these purposes are plug, hoe and cultivator. Okay, students, now plugging. Okay, that is done by a plug. This is being used since ancient times for tilting the soil, adding fertilizers to the crop, removing the weeds, scraping of soil, etc. This implement is made up of wood and is drawn by a pair of bulls or other animals. Okay, so here in figure 1.1a, the figure of plug is being given. It is basically made up of wood, a long wooden, okay, which has been attached with an iron. Okay, and this edge is sharpened, and what happens, and this is like this long way, it has been attached with animals like what, like bulls, like ox and all that. Okay, now here it is said that this implement is made up of wood, as I have told you, and is drawn by a pair of bulls or other animals. Okay, like horses, camels, etc. It contains a strong triangular iron strip which is called as plug shore. So what is this plug shore? This triangular iron strip. Okay, students, the main part of plug is a long log of wood, and as I have told you that there is a long wood. Okay, this is what, long log of wood, which is called as plug shaft. There is a handle at one end of the shaft. The other end is attached to a beam which is placed on the bulls. Next, one pair of bulls and a man can easily operate the plug. Okay, so here this portion is been put into another wood, which has been, they are tying with using the ropes. Okay, they are been drawn with the help of the animals, like here ox, it can be horses, or it can be any camel. Yeah, this is basically what, this is this is used since ancient time. Okay, since very from beginning of agriculture only, this way is been used. Okay, in the agriculture, the indigenous wooden plug is increasingly being replaced by iron plugs nowadays. Okay, now what this wooden plug is been replaced by iron plugs. Yeah, now next is hoe. Hoe is also what? It is also an implement or device or any instrument which can be used for plugging. Okay, it is simple tool which is used for removing weeds and for loosening the soil. As we have already learned that loosening of soil is been very very important in the process of agriculture, okay, or in the growing in the process of growing any crops or in agriculture. Okay, so hoe is also a tool, very simple tool which is used for removing the weeds and for loosening the soil. And what is this weeds about actually? Weeds are, we have seen in that in the field there are many unwanted or undesirable crops or plants are being grown along with the main crop. Okay, so these unwanted plants or crops we consider as what? Weeds. Okay students, and you know the removal of weed is also very essential, because we know that obviously it is also a plant, so when it will grow along with main crop, it will also utilize the same amount of nutrients which are been available for the main crop. It will also occupy the space which are been available for the growth of main crop. At the same time, it will also utilize the sunlight. So hence, all the things or all the essential requirements which are been provided for main crop are been used by these weeds. Okay, so it is very necessary to take out the weeds from the soil. Okay, it has a long rod of wood or iron. So we are discussing here about the hoe. Hoe is basically what? It's a, we can say it is a simple device, and it is consists of the long rod of wood or iron. A strong, broad, and bent plate of iron is fixed to one of its end, and is works like a blade. It is pulled by animals. So in figure 1.1b you can check there is the diagram of hoe given. Okay, as I told you that it is also consist of what? Wood and what? Iron blade. Here it is. So this is also used by the farmers for plugging or loosening of the soil. Next is cultivator. Nowadays plugging is done by a tractor driven cultivator. The use of cultivator saves labor and time. So according to the change with the time, now the modern way which most of the farmers they are using, that is the use of the cultivators. Okay, so this helps in saving a lot of money and labor also. Okay, it saves the labor and time, and easily they can loosen the soil. Okay students, now our first agriculture practices, the first step, that is preparation of soil, is being completed. I hope you all understood. Now coming to the next topic, that is the sowing. Sowing means, now already we have prepared the soil. Now what we need to do? We need to sow the seeds in the field which we have already prepared for growing a particular crop. Okay, so sowing is the most important part of crop production. Before sowing, good quality seeds are selected. Good quality seeds are clean and healthy seeds of a good variety. Farmers prefer to use seeds which give a high yield. Now as I told you that sowing is what? The process of putting the seeds into the soil. Okay students, or that is only we say. So when we are sowing the seeds, it is very very essential to keep few things in our mind. For example, if we take the healthy food, a healthy seed, good quality of seeds which are clean, which are healthy, then obviously the yield of our crop will be very high. Clear? Okay, so few things which we should keep in our mind while we are sowing the seeds. That is selection of seeds. We need to select all the seeds which are healthy, which are free from any disease, okay, which are of good quality. Then only we can expect a good yield of the crops. Clear, students? Next, are their seeds which float on water, would those be lighter or heavier? That means here in activity 1.1, okay, it is asked to do some activity and we need to find out that which seeds are been good, healthier or not. Okay, so basically the seeds which are damaged or which are not fully grown in like that or unhealthy seeds that float easily on the surface of the water if we put in any glass or any beaker, okay, whereas the seeds which are healthy, which grow well, that remains or at the bottom of the glass or any beaker. Okay, so in this way we can choose the good quality of the seeds. So this is a good method for separating good healthy seeds from the damaged ones. Before sowing, one of the important tasks is to know about the tools used for sowing seeds. Now we studied already what is sowing and what we need to keep in our mind, that is the selection of seeds. If we are selecting a seed which is of the good quality, which is healthier and which is fully grown, then we can sow in the particular field and we can expect good yield of crops. Clear, students? Now here in next topic, some traditional tools which are being mentioned for sowing of the seeds. Okay, traditional tool. The tool used traditionally for sowing seed is shaped like a funnel. The seeds are filled into the funnel, passed down through two or three pipes having the sharp ends. These ends pierce into the soil and place seeds there. So here you can see the funnel shaped tool. Okay, it is a funnel shaped tool. What farmers they are doing, they are putting the seeds into this funnel shape, and when they are plugging in that land or in that soil, the seeds are being sown and at particular distance and in a proper way. Clear, students? Next, the another method, that is the seed drill. Also, seed drill is also a traditional tool, or it is also a tool which has been used mainly for sowing of the crop, seeds of particular crop. Okay, and this is mentioned in figure 1.2, a seed drill. I hope many of you all are knowing about these things. Nowadays, seed drill is used for sowing with the help of tractors. Basically, it has been used with the help of the tractors for sowing of the seeds of particular crop. This tool sows the seeds uniformly at proper distances and depths. It ensures that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. This prevents damage caused by the birds. Sowing by using a seed drill saves time and labor. So, an appropriate distance between the seed is important to avoid overcrowding of plants. This allows plants to grow sufficient sunlight, nutrients and water from the soil. Sometimes a few plants have to be removed to prevent the overcrowding. Now, when we are sowing the seeds, certain things we need to remember in our mind, or we need to keep in our mind. For example, if we are sowing the seeds, all the seeds has to be sown at particular distance. Okay, so what happens, they can grow well, they can have the their nutrients which are required for them in a proper way. Okay, otherwise when the seeds are been grown at nearby, means near to one another, so they do not get sufficient place to grow. Okay, and that overcrowding is not good, because if the crops seeds of a particular crop are being overcrowded, they will not get sufficient amount of sunlight, nutrients, water from the soil, and they will not grow well. Yeah. Next is adding manure and fertilizers. As we know that manures are being obtained from the dead or decaying parts of plant as well as animals. Okay, so basically the function or the importance of manure and fertilizers in adding to the soil is to enhance the fertility of the soil. Okay students, so we will discuss here about the adding of the manure and fertilizers. The substances which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for healthy growth of crops are called manure and fertilizers. As we know that after cropping of plants, each time when the crops are being harvested, there is always the deficiency or the lack of nutrients in the soil. So before sowing the seeds of any particular crop, we need to make ensure that whether the soil is having sufficient amount of nutrients or not. Otherwise, when the soil is lacking with particular type of nutrients, the crops will not grow well. Clear, students? Okay, so whatever the substances which we are adding in the soil as the supplement nutrients for the healthy growth of plants, we will say it is called manure or fertilizers. Soil supplies mineral nutrients to the crop. These nutrients are essential for the growth of plants. In certain areas, farmers grow crop after crop in the same field. The field is never left uncultivated or fallow. Imagine what happens to the nutrients. We know that at few places, farmers after growing one crop, in next season also they are growing the crop. Means continuously they are growing the crops. In this way, if they are doing the they are growing the crops, the plants will, or the crop plants will not get sufficient or adequate amount of nutrients. Okay, and obviously it will affect to the yield of that particular crop. So we need to make sure that the nutrients which are being availed by the particular crop will be supplied in proper amount. Clear? So continuous growing of crops makes the soil poor in certain nutrients. Therefore, farmers have to add manure to the fields to replenish the soil with nutrients. This process is called as manuring. Improper or insufficient manuring results in weak plants. So as I said that if farmers will grow on the crops continuously, so that will result into the poorer nutrients in the soil. And obviously, if there is a lack of nutrients in the soil, the plants will not grow well and we will not have the good amount of crop yield. Okay, so we need to make sure before growing of the crops that particular soil has sufficient amount of the nutrients. Clear? So we are basically adding for fulfilling the requirement of nutrients only, we are adding what? Manure and fertilizers. Clear, students? So manure is an organic substance obtained from the decomposition of plant or animal waste. Farmers dump plant and animal waste in the pits at one open place and allow it to decompose. The decomposition is caused by some microorganisms. The decomposed matter is used as organic manure. Okay. So as I explained you previously in class 6 also, in 7th also, that manures are being prepared by the farmers by using the dead and decaying matter of the plants and animals. okay, when they fill that in a particular pit, they allow it to decompose by the microorganisms. It takes little time to get prepared of the manure, but ultimately that manure is been rich with the humus, and you all must be knowing it very well that humus is really very very helpful or essential for the growth of particular type of crop or plant. Okay, so for today only this much topic I'm going to explain. The remaining topics we will cover in the previous lecture, in the coming lecture, okay, in the next session or next class. Dear students, so today's homework for everybody to learn what I have explained today, what I have explained about the various implements, okay, and why it is important to plug the soil, what is the preparation of soil, and when we sow the particular seed, why, what are the things which we should keep in our mind. Clear? So I hope whatever topics I have explained you today is clear, and if you find any difficulty you can clear it when we will have the regular classes, you can ask. Okay, thank you students.